Hey guys, you're watching Irish Vanita. It's me, Manju. Today, I'm going to share few tips and guidelines how you can become a registered nurse in Ireland. So, before going into the detail, you can check yourself your eligibility. For that, you should be a registered nurse in your own country and you should have an experience of at least 1 year, and the most important thing, you should have given your IELTS or OET. If you are an IELTS candidate, you should have a score of 7 overall in academic, and for reading and listening it should be 6.5 individually, and for writing and speaking it's 7. And if it is OET, you should get C+ in reading and listening and B in writing and speaking. Now the last one, if you guys really have a passion to progress your career as a nurse in Ireland, then you are the right candidate to register in NMBI. NMPI is a Nursing and Midwifery Board of Ireland. It's a regulatory body for the profession of nursing and midwifery in Ireland. To make it simple, NMPI has made the registration process in 5 simple steps. Anybody can do it. So, step 1, you have to request for your overseas registration application request form. For this, you have to go into the NMBI website, that is www.nmbi.ie. You can see the link to download this request form. Once you have downloaded this form, they'll be asking you for few details. In my point of view, this application form is very simple, clear, and straightforward. Anybody can fill it out. And in this application form, you have to fill few of your details. First one, your personal details, your contact details, your registration details, TRF number, that is your test reference number of the IELTS, and your OET candidate number. You guys make sure that don't make any mistake in filling this number, because once verifying your test reference number, only the NMBI is going to deliver you with your application form. And the last one is your payment detail. You have to pay an amount of €350 paid in your credit card or debit card. Once this application pack is done, you can send it directly to the address given in the NMBI website. Now your step 1 is done. Step 2. You will be receiving an application pack. Once you receive your application pack, you can see a reference number. So, this is the number you have to keep safely until the end of your process. Next one, you have to create a username and password with the NMBI website. This makes you to track your application status throughout your process. And in this application pack, there will be 2 sessions. Both the sessions are mandatory. Section 1 to be completed by the applicant, and the Section 2 has to be completed by the relevant authorities. In Session 1, they'll be asking you for few details like your personal detail, your contact detail, your identity document, it's nothing but your passport. But NMBI website says that you can give your birth certificate or marriage certificate if you don't have your current passport at the moment. But to my point, it's always better to give the passport as identity document. Furthermore, they'll be asking you like your professional qualification, your reference number, your employer reference, your registration, and few more details. So, this has to be completed by the applicant and you can send it directly to the NMBI. Now, the third session is to be completed by the relevant authorities. Let me just tell you who are all the relevant authorities. First one is the CCPS, Certificate of Current Profession. This has to be completed by the Nursing Registration Council. So, maybe you might have worked under different registration council. Make sure you get signature from all the registration council you have worked under. And the next one is the transcript. Make sure you just get your theoretical and practical in a correct manner. And the third one is your employer reference. So, you could have worked under different employers. For all the employer reference should be included in this form. And the last one is your professional qualification, that's where you have completed your graduation. So this is the end of the section 3, and one important point is that These forms that are completed by the relevant authorities should be sent directly from those authorities. If you are the one going to send these forms, NMBR is going to refuse these forms. And session 4. This is the session the NMBR is going to assess you. So, usually the NMBR website says that it takes around 90 days, but it depends upon the time when all the forms reaches the NMBR. So, there is no correct time, or we cannot say that it will be done by 90 days, but make sure you just keep an eye whether the relevant authorities are sending the form in time. So, this is the end of the session 4. Now, the last one is the decision letter, most crucial and important one. NMBR is going to give 4 different decisions. First one is you are eligible for registration. This normally applies for the European candidates who trained in Europe countries. And the second one is they are going to ask you for further information. And the third one is maybe you have to undergo either an adaptation or an aptitude test to register yourself in Ireland. And the last one is they are going to refuse your application. But if you are not satisfied with the decision of the NMBI, you can just appeal within 56 days of your decision letter, so that NMBR is going to reassess your application process. So, at the end, maybe NMBR will hold the same decision, but they are going to ask you for further information. And the last one, they are going to give you a new decision. So, this is the 5 different steps in NMBR process. It doesn't mean that you have to wait for an interview to begin your registration. You can make your registration by yourself, wait for a good employer to hire you, then you can make your visa processing much easy and you can land up in Ireland much quickly. Meet you with another interesting video. Until then, it's me, Manju, signing off. Bye-bye.